It is Sunday morning, and it is Resurrection Sunday. And I hope that you had a great week and meditated and remembered the Lord this week, as this week was called Passion Week. And then on Wednesday, of course, was Passover. And I hope that you guys celebrated and remembered the Lord. But today, of course, is Resurrection Sunday. And I just trust and hope that all of you are doing well. And I wanted to say thank you to all of your faithfulness in your giving and in the tithing and the offerings. So keep it coming. God is helping us along this journey. So we just appreciate all of your faithfulness and your contributions to the church. Luke chapter 6, verse 38 says, give and it will be given to you. Let me read it again. Give and it will be given to you. They will pour it into your lap, good measure, pressed down, shaken over, or shaken together and running over. For by your standard of measure, it will be measured to you in return. So what we give and what we plant as far as our finances to help to meet the need of the ministry, we have this promise. It'll be pressed down, shaken together, and running over. So thank you. Thank you so much. Now, today, of course, we're celebrating Resurrection Sunday. And my message, of course, is going to be about the resurrection. So I'm going to title my message today, and it's going to be called Resurrection Power Every Day. But before we go into the Word of God, I want to pray and ask God to help us and make sure that you have your Bibles open. We do have the privilege of having the slideshow available for you, but it would be good if you had your Bibles and you can turn and a piece of paper as well as a pen or a pencil and to take notes and allow the Holy Spirit just to speak to you as this word goes out into the airwaves and as you're watching that and as you're listening. So let's pray though before we get started. Father, we thank you for this privilege that we have, Father, to celebrate, Lord, the greatest demonstration of love in the history of mankind. And we pray, Father God, that, Lord, you will help us as we listen to the Word of God, as we remember what you've done for us, God. We pray, Lord, that you'll lead us and guide us through this time as we share the Word of God. Lord, give us ears to hear, God. Give us hearts to receive. And may the Word of God not return to us void, but may it accomplish what you want it to accomplish. And Father, we'll be sure and crown everything back to you, giving you all of the honor and all of the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said, amen. And so I want to begin my message, as I said already, resurrection power every day. Now, if we're celebrating Resurrection Sunday once a year, then I think we're missing out. And because we can live and we can walk in resurrection day, and because he's every day. Now, if we're celebrating Resurrection Sunday once a year, then I think we're missing out. And because we can live and we can walk in resurrection power every single day. And because he's risen and he lives in us, and so we can experience that. But the thing is, a lot of people don't understand how to live in that resurrected power. So that's what we're going to talk about today. We're going to give you four points on the resurrection power that's inside of you. We're going to talk about activating it, and we're going to learn how this resurrection power works in our lives on a daily basis. Now, this is a special day that we celebrate. We celebrate the love. We celebrate the power on this special day that commemorates, of course, we know the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, which he experienced willingly to provide for us. So he gave his life for us willingly, and he gave us an abundant life for us to live now and forever. So it's not just for now, but it's also forever. And so it's celebrated, of course, as I said, by most people just once a year. But its power wasn't meant to be just celebrated once a year. Its power was meant for us to live and operate in that resurrection power every single day of our lives. Now, where did it all start? It started off when Jesus's death, of course, I said that already, burial, were all part of the plan of redemption. So we see that the burial and resurrection were all part of the plan of redemption. With Adam, of course, gave his power over to Satan in the Garden of Eden by his act of disobedience. But the good news is that was taken back by the perfect man, Jesus, in his obedience. So God reclaimed the blessing that was stolen in the garden and got his family back. And so he gave us back the dominion. He gave us back the authority that rightfully belonged to us as his children. So that's the good news. So we're operating in something that we are given to by God, and we have a right to operate in that. And so when Jesus arose from the dead after being crucified, a voice echoed through the universe in the scripture that we remember, "It is finished." And so all the work on the cross and the death, burial, and resurrection, the work that he came to do is finished. And now it's time for us to operate in that. And so Jesus left hell in shambles and totally and completely devastated. Satan was defeated, conquered, and under Jesus' feet when all of this happened. And so that means he's not going to be defeated. Satan is already defeated. And so when we are celebrating that, always remember that Satan is already defeated because of what Jesus Christ had done through the death, burial, and resurrection. Now, a scripture that I want to share with you before we get to our very first point is found in Colossians chapter 2, verse 15. Colossians chapter 2, verse 15, it says, "Having disarmed principalities and powers, he made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them in it." So he triumphed over the devil, triumphed over all the principalities and powers, triumphed over the kingdom of darkness, and he disarmed every power that could take a stand against us. So he disarmed that by him defeating and disarming the principalities and powers. Now, it seems like they're operating and they're having an influence in our lives, but they don't have to. And the way that we can avoid them having influence in our lives is to truly understand the power of this resurrection that we're talking about today. Jesus sealed Satan's defeat, and it is done once and for all. So look at your neighbor and say, "It's done. It is done." And so Satan has no power over you unless you give him the power. And he has no authority unless you give him the authority. And so Jesus did the final work, the finished work, to seal his defeat. And I'm talking about Satan. Now, we need to live in that finished work that Jesus Christ did and finished on the cross, the work of the resurrection power. But a lot of Christians don't understand that. And I keep saying that over and over again. They don't understand and they don't realize the power that is living inside of them. And so this power that's living inside of them, of us Christians, most Christians don't cross over and take full advantage of all that Jesus provided. And so, but you can. And so we can start with that today when we're talking about these four different points that I want to bring out, how we can live in that resurrection power every day. So the first point that I want to bring out is we have to activate the resurrection power inside of you. So we have to activate the resurrection power inside of you. Philippians chapter 3, verse 10 says, "I want to know Christ and experience the mighty power that raised him from the dead." So, you know, we can experience that. And that's what Paul was saying. "I want to know Christ and experience the mighty power that raised him from the dead." So it's much more than just being saved and then we're done. It's experiencing the mighty power that he wants to work in and through us. And it came when Jesus was raised from the dead. Now, there is no Christianity, as we know, without the cross And there is no Christianity without the resurrection. So we have to marry those two together. Christianity is because of the cross and because of the resurrection. So it's the core of everything we believe, we receive, and experience in the earth, and therefore in heaven. And so every Christian believes and receives salvation, but sadly, most of the people who accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, sadly, they don't receive the most powerful force and realize that God has the most powerful force in the universe, and yet most people are not activating that. So it's not operating in the fullness of the resurrection power that is available to every one of us. So it's available to us. So resurrection power is on the inside of us. So you just point right here and say that resurrection power is on the inside of us. You can look at your neighbor and say the resurrection power is already inside of you. And so the anointing of the power of Jesus's resurrection that you have received from him abides in us right now. We don't have to wait for it. It's already there. And when you activate it, it does something. The activation of the resurrection power that's inside of you, it begins to manifest and it begins to do something. And what does it do? Well, it removes burdens and it destroys yokes. And the resurrection power of God is the most powerful force in the universe, yet it has no power in your life until you activate it. So a lot of times we have things and unless we activate it. I know that sometimes we get credit cards or we get debit cards and we can't use the debit card that we get in the mail until we do what? Well, we call the number and we activate that. And the same thing is with the resurrection power that's inside of you. We have it sitting there, but unless we activate that, and I'll tell you how we're going to do that as we move on in this lesson today. And so, but the good news is we already have it as born again believers. So now I'm going to tell you how we activate that. So there's three simple steps that we activate it. First step is believe it. Believe it. So being born again won't cause resurrection power to automatically operate in your life, but you have to choose to believe it. So we have to make a decision believing it. So believing is what activates the power in your life. You have to have that confidence and you have to believe that. You activate resurrection power when you allow Jesus Christ to come into your life. So that's the starting point as your Lord and Savior. But think about what that accomplished. It accomplished deliverance. It accomplished forgiveness and being made right with God himself. So that's what salvation brought to us. And that's a lot of power, but you had not activated by faith, by believing. So that's what we have to do. Salvation brings us deliverance. It brings us forgiveness and it makes us right with God. But we want to see the activation of the resurrection power operating in our lives. And it has to be activated by our faith, by I believe that I have the resurrection power in my life. So we access all these benefits, healing and abundance and peace and joy and good things. And every good thing that God has available for you. So we have to believe it. It's the same as having faith. So faith into action to receive the full resurrection power in your life. The second thing is we have to, after we believe it, now we have to speak it. And when you speak it, you have to believe. When you believe that resurrection power is residing in you, you begin to activate it through your words. So when you believe the power of God is inside of you and the power of the resurrection is inside of you, it will. You have to not only believe it, but you have to have faith-filled words and you have to speak it. If the spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you, he will make you alive. He will make your mortal body alive. Notice it doesn't say he will make alive your glorified flesh, but your mortal flesh. That's resurrection power coming out of God from his word into your spirit. And I'm referring to Romans chapter 8, verse 11. And I'll quote that scripture in just a moment again. And so every time that we speak the name of Jesus or plead the blood of Jesus over our situation, Satan is reminded of his defeat. See, a lot of times we're deactivating our power when we begin to speak opposite things. We begin to speak negative things. We begin to speak the problems, not the solution. But when we begin to speak, the resurrection power for deliverance will happen. The abundance of God in our lives. Every time that we speak out the name of Jesus and plead the blood of Jesus, we are reminding the devil that he's already defeated. And so that's believing it and speaking it. The third thing is act on it. So now we have to act on it. So we can't make no mistake. Satan's defeat was sealed by the resurrection, but we must enforce it or act on it. And so the very same power that raised Christ from the dead is now living in you. And God raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. And Satan is defeated. So just say, Satan, you are defeated because I have the resurrection power living in me. So you're defeated. And when he tries to bring the curse back into your life, he's trespassing into an area that he is not allowed to be in. So don't give him permission. You have the authority to make him leave, and now we can act on it. So don't wait any longer. Act on it right now. So make sure that we believe it, that we speak it, and we act on it. Now, how do we do this? How do we do this? Well, applying the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, God's power to every situation. So what we do is we're applying the name of Jesus. That's how we do it. And we plead the blood of Jesus to every situation. For example, I gave to you guys all a psalm that you could speak and pray over your lives every day, to read every day over your life. And that's Psalm 91. So when you're reading Psalms 91, you're not only proclaiming the name of Jesus, but you're also praying and declaring and decreeing the covering of God's protection. Well, that's what the blood does. The blood of Jesus, when we plead the blood, it is protecting us, and it's keeping us in a place where the enemy doesn't have a right to attack us. So this power in the name of Jesus, we apply it, the blood of Jesus, and it's God's power to every situation in your life. So every situation that we're contending with right now, when sickness comes, tries to come, we have to apply the blood of Jesus, the resurrection power. So that's when sickness comes. So every day, you know, if I'm not feeling well, I know the symptoms are there, but I'm praying in the name of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus that by Jesus' stripes, I am healed. And I say it over and over and over again until I reach that place in faith. And I begin to experience the resurrection power of God operating and touching my body, and healing begins to move upon my life. And this can happen to you as well. And so Satan is defeated. And when he tries to bring it, when he tries to bring it back up, you don't listen to what he has to say. So we have the resurrection power. Now, if lack tries to take up residence in our life, a lot of us, even now that we're dealing with this crisis, this corona, and people are losing their jobs, getting laid off, and we're experiencing some lack in areas in our lives. Well, when that happens, don't let it take residence in your life. In other words, it may be there, but we can do something about it, and we can begin to plead the blood of Jesus. We can begin to declare the curse of lack in our life. And the enemy, and begin to claim that the enemy is defeated and that we have triumphed because Jesus won for you on the cross. So don't ever accept defeat in your life. Jesus paid a high price, or too high of a price, for you to accept anything less than total complete victory. And so I just want you to be encouraged with that. So that's activating the resurrection power of God inside of you. The second thing is, live healed through resurrection power. So we can live healed through the resurrection power. Here's that text that I wanted to give to you, Romans chapter 8, verse 11. I referred to it a moment ago. It says this: but if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, He that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit dwelleth in you. Romans 8:11. So when you made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life, the Holy Spirit imparted into you the same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead and brought him out of hell, and the same power that defeated the principalities are inside of you and the powers. So we have something that we possess, and a lot of people don't know that. And so you were made alive together with him, meaning Jesus Christ, and the very same Spirit, because God is only one. There's only one. He's one. He is a Spirit, but he's able to distribute that one Spirit and deposit it into every born-again believer. So the very same Spirit, the same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead is living inside of you. It's that resurrection power. And we can live in that resurrection power every single day of our lives. You're not qualified to bear sin, sickness, disease, and demons, and Jesus, because Jesus took care of all of that. So whatever you're going through in your body, whatever you're going through spiritually, whatever you're going through, you just have to put the resurrection power to work today, starting right now in Jesus' name, because Jesus died so you could live. So our part in this, of course, is to resist everything that tries to come on us that Jesus already bore for us on the cross. So we have to resist those things, and that's our job. That's what we're required to do. He already bore our sins, so we have to resist the sin and the temptations. And so we have the power to resist it. So we have to resist it. And he bore our sickness and disease, so we can resist sickness and disease. Instead of being tempted just to lay down and put up with it, we can resist it. So I know it may take a lot for us to resist when these temptations sometimes overwhelm us, but when we have the power of the Holy Spirit living in us, the power of the resurrection, and we realize that and we believe it and we speak it as well as act on it on a regular basis, then the resisting of all of those things will not be so difficult. And so we have to make it a lifestyle for all of us to live in this resurrecting power. And that means staying in the Word and praying on a regular basis, on a daily basis. And so to walk in resurrection power, we have to believe it, right? We have to speak it, and we have to act on it and act on our healing and our deliverance. So we expect the power of God in our physical bodies, in our situation, to manifest and do its work in the same way that it did in the life of Jesus Christ, as well as his followers in the Bible. And so that's live healed through the resurrection power of God. The third thing is, we have the third one here is live the Zoe life. We see the third point that I want to make, live the Zoe life through resurrection power. And so we see a scripture here in Revelation chapter 1, verse 18. I am he who lives and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. And I have the keys of Hades and of death. Revelation chapter 1, verse 18. So Jesus came to bring us a new life. And the word of life in the Greek, and I said live the Zoe life through resurrection power. Well, Zoe is a Greek word, and it means the God kind of life, and which charging through our very being. So the Zoe power of God is the God kind of life charging through our very being. So that's already living in us. So living in Zoe power life means that God keeps on making life in our bodies, because Zoe is eternal. So this power that I'm talking about is not temporary. It's not going away. It lives on forever. And that's how we're able to live on after we leave this world that we're living in, when we pass and we go to heaven or whatever, however we leave this world out through the rapture or we die a physical death. So it's an ongoing life that we get to enjoy. The resurrection life is designed to continuously upgrade and renew even our physical beings. Now, that's how God intended for it to be. Now, in Genesis chapter 6, verse 3, it talks about living 100 years, 120 years. And if our bodies are designed to live 120 years, I know we're promised 70 years. But in Genesis 6, 3, our bodies will have to experience, if we're going to live long, we're going to have to experience the Zoe power operating in our life and allow the life of God to continuously replenish us and renew our physical bodies. So activating resurrection power by confessing the following. This is what we have to do to activate the resurrection power is we have to confess the following. Because of Jesus' resurrection life in me. And this is what I want you to repeat after me. Repeat after me. Because of Jesus' resurrection life in me, I'm getting stronger and stronger every day. My eyes are seeing more clearly. My ears are hearing better. My mind is functioning perfectly, and every bone, organ, nerve, ligament is daily being supercharged by the glory of God. So the same spirit that raised up Jesus from the dead is now living in me and is constantly making alive my mortal flesh. Again, referring back to Romans chapter 8, verse 11. Psalms 103, verse 5 says, my days are being lengthened, and my youth is renewed like eagles. And isn't that a great promise? Isn't that a great scripture that we can stand on? And that's how we activate it. You know, we speak it out. We believe it. We receive it. And we act on the word of God. Remember, the word won't work unless we work the word. So resurrection life is available to every born-again believer, to all of us. In fact, it's available to all of humanity if they would just take the first step by accepting Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. And so this resurrection life is available to all of us, but we must receive it by faith. We must embrace it and daily recognize the life of God and that it is the life of God in our lives and that it's dwelling in us and making alive our mortal flesh. And so this must become a reality for us. We have to be conscious of that. We should wake up every morning and we should declare the resurrection life of God is living in me today. Not just on the morning of Resurrection Sunday, Easter Sunday, but every single day. So make this your goal. Make this your aim that you'll wake up every day and you'll begin to declare the resurrection power, the resurrection life of God is living in me today. And when we say that every single day, believe it, receive it, and act on it. Amen. And so that's the resurrection power that we see live the Zoe life through the resurrection power. Now, final one is the fourth point that I want to bring out for you today. And the fourth one is live free with resurrection power. Live free with resurrection power. The Bible says in John chapter 8, verse 36, so if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed. So resurrection power frees you from the bondage of sin and from your past. A lot of believers are still living in their past. They still feel condemned. They still have guilt in their life. And the reason why is they've not activated the resurrecting power of God to be able to live free from the guilt and condemnation. Your part in Jesus' crucifixion and his suffering, what we have to do is to walk in resurrection power. Now, Paul said something interesting in Philippians chapter 3, verse 13. He said this. He said in Philippians chapter 3, verse 13, he said, when he talked about to forget those things that are behind you, and reaching forward to what is ahead of you. And so what he's saying here is, I'm not going to give power to my past, because he had a past. We all have a past before we came to Christ. And we can't live in that past, because when we live in the past, we then begin to live powerless lives, not powerful lives. So in order for us to live free with resurrection power, we have to say goodbye to yesterday And we have to say hello to the resurrection power that we have right now living in us. And so the question that I want to ask you is, do you know why Jesus shed his blood? You know, a lot of times people are wondering, why did he shed his blood? Well, it's simple, to get rid of yesterday. Just a short little definition here, to get rid of yesterday. And so when we think about it, if anyone, in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, the Bible says, if anyone is in Christ, he is a what? He is a new creation. Old things have passed away. And so we have, the old things have passed away. So now the old things of yesterday need to be forgotten. Don't remember those things. Don't bring those things up. The only time we can bring them up is when we're giving God the glory and the praise in our testimony. But don't visit those things on a regular basis, and don't allow the enemy to plant thoughts in your mind of yesterday. Yesterday's gone, today's here, and we're going to move forward to reach our tomorrows and reach our destinies. And so now Romans chapter 6, verse 4, we have another scripture here that says, therefore, we are buried with him by baptism into death. That's talking about Jesus Christ. We are buried with him into death. Even so, we also walk in newness of life. And so that's what water baptism is a symbol of. It symbolizes that, you know what, the death and the burial and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And now we walk in newness of life. So when we're born again, forgiven of all of our sins, he then fills us and he empowers us with his resurrection power, enabling us to live a free life and to live free from all of the things of the past and begin to live free and not allow those things to keep you trapped. So as a believer, you have residing in you the same new life God gave Jesus when he was raised from the dead. The old sinner you once were has died. You know, a lot of people who are saved, and I know we say it and we're trying to be humble when we're saying, I'm just still a sinner saved by grace. Well, I am no longer a sinner, but I am saved by grace because of the power of God that's living in me. See, we've got to become a new creation on the inside of it. We have to understand that we have become a new creation inside, and we are full of the resurrection life of God living in us. We have to understand that. We have to believe it. We have to receive it. But sometimes sin, and we still struggle with sin. So all of us still are contending in some capacity, at least have sinned sometime in our Christian walk with God. And so, but sin like disobedience and living a selfish carnal life will keep that resurrection life from flowing out. So remember, sin, disobedient, being rebellious are things that keep the power or the resurrection power to manifest and operate in our life. So sin will separate you from the power of God. And even though you're born again, so we're not saying you're not born again, but what we are saying is the resurrection power of God won't operate in our lives if we have sin in our lives. So we have to make sure that we repent of our sins every single day so that the resurrection power can be activated in our life. Resurrection life will lay only dormant in us when we walk in sin. And so we don't want it to lay dormant in us. So there's a couple ways that it lays dormant in us: not knowing how to activate it and living, but we're living right with for God. And the other one is it's not being activated because we have sin in our life. So we don't want sin to overtake us. So we have to do something. We have to make a solid decision. I'm going to stop sinning. So we overcome it by walking after the new life. We overcome it that God has put within us. So that's how we overcome it, that I'm going to walk in the new life of God that is already in me. And I'm going to do that. And how I'm going to do that is by spending time in the Word of God and in prayer. You're never wasting any time when you're reading the Word of God. And it's a very valuable resource for you to read the Word of God, because it is our blueprint. It is our manual that guides us into living in the way that God wants us to live. And prayer is our dialogue and our communication with God. So we need both on a regular basis. Can you imagine if you're married or you have children that are living with you and you never spend any time with them? Your relationship is not growing. You're not talking to each other. You don't even know what's going on in that person's life. But when you have a continuous communication with your loved ones and your spouses and your children, then you begin to hear what they're saying, and they get to hear what you're saying, and you're building a relationship. And that's what God wants. He wants a relationship. He wants us to have a relationship with him. And the way that we can do that is also reading the Word of God every single day and praying to him every single day and build relationship with him. And that sets us on the course of growing and maturing in our walk with him. And as we do that, the Spirit of God will strengthen you and enable you to put that sin under your feet. And so the Word of God is a mirror that reflects, and it begins to reveal to us things in our lives that we need to ask God and repent and ask God to forgive us. So the first step today that we want to take that's going to help us is by asking for his help. And, you know, a lot of times we have pride and we don't want to deal with that, and we don't want to pray and ask God for help. But that's how that's where we have to begin. We have to begin by saying, Lord, I desire to experience the power to live by this new life every day. You have to have a desire. You have to have a passion. And by a decision of my heart. So I have to make a decision that I want this resurrection power, that I want this daily walk with God. I have to have that in my heart, and I have to put down the dictates of sin, and I have to declare myself to be dead to the sin in Jesus' name. And I have to make a decision that I will spend time in prayer and in the Word of God. And as I do, I believe and I'll receive a Holy Spirit refreshing in my life. So I believe I'll begin to live out the resurrection power that God has placed within me. And so there's activity that's happening. You have to put in the work. You have to put the work into the walk of God, in your walk with God, if you're going to see the resurrection power operating in your life. Sometimes we always want something for free. We want God to be the one to do everything. But earlier I said, he said, it is finished. And so what that means is it's now for us to receive what he finished and begin to walk that out in our life. And let me just get ready to close and wrap this message up. But I want to end by saying, you know, the resurrection power sets you free from sin, shame, and living in the past. So that's what it sets us free from. And it also sets you free from fear. A lot of people are in fear now. A lot of people are worried. A lot of people have anxiety. And so you don't want to experience fear in your life. And if you're experiencing fear in your life, if you're experiencing worries in your life, anxiety in your life, know this, that Jesus defeated fear. I think last week I talked about no fear. God did not give us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. So you don't have to ever fear again. It doesn't belong to you. It doesn't come from God. Jesus took it all, and you are delivered from that. And that resurrection power that's living in you means you don't have to be afraid of anything. So fear was defeated in the pit of hell for you. Okay, so it's already done. He's already took care of it. So you don't have to be in fear over anything. You don't have to be fearful of anything, what's happening, of people, or of the crisis in which we're living, in your health or your future, when we have the resurrection power operating in your life. So we can go free in Jesus' name. So when you activate the resurrection power, you live healed, you live the Zoe life, and live free. And you will live in resurrection power every day. And as we celebrate, I know we're celebrating Resurrection Sunday, but as we're celebrating this, make it your aim that, you know what, every day I'm going to wake up and I'm going to activate the resurrection power of God in my spirit. I'm going to stir the faith and activate the resurrection power in my life. And that's the reason why we can celebrate every single day, because he is risen indeed. I hope you received something from this message. I know that I probably was speed preaching, but listen to this message over and over and over again. As we said a moment ago, we'll go back over the points. Activate the resurrection power inside of you. The second one, live healed through resurrection power. Live the Zoe life through resurrection power. And fourthly, live free with resurrection power. And before we close in prayer, I want to just say this. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, there may be people who are not born again that are listening to this. Or maybe you had experienced a walk with God before, but you walked away from God, and you want to recommit and you want to rededicate your life, and you're there and you're listening. I want you to know that we can pray this simple little prayer. And if you believe it with your heart, the words that you're praying, then you will begin to experience a new life in Christ Jesus. And you will experience what's called a born-again experience. And you will begin to experience the resurrection power of God in your life. So just pray this prayer with me. Dear Lord Jesus, I know that I've sinned against you, but I've come to realize that I can be forgiven. I come to realize that I can rededicate my life back to you. So I acknowledge the fact, Lord, that I have sinned against you, but I ask you to forgive me. I ask you to forgive me for all of my sins. I believe that you died for me. I believe that you rose again so that I can have the resurrection power. So I open my heart to you right now, Lord, and I ask you to come and live in me. And I believe it and I receive it by faith that I am born again, and now baptize me with your Holy Spirit. And I pray these things in the mighty name of Jesus. I believe it and receive it in Jesus' name. Now, if you prayed that prayer and you meant it with your heart, I want you to tell somebody as soon as you see somebody. Just tell somebody right away. Call somebody, text somebody, let them know what decision that you had made. And I also like for you to contact us here. We've got email address. We've got telephone numbers that are available for you. You can call, let us know. And we want to put something in your hands that will help you strengthen your walk with God. And so I just want to say congratulations if you prayed that prayer. And remember, the resurrection power is on the inside of you and already. So remember, life goes better when God is first. And as I always say in Hebrews chapter 13, the Lord promised us he'd never leave us nor forsake us. So that means you'll never walk alone. So let me just release you in a closing prayer. Father, we thank you for this word. And we pray, Father, that every day we would experience the resurrection power of God in our life. And I pray now that you cover us with your precious blood. Keep us healthy. Keep us strong. Make us healthy and wealthy and prosperous in every area of our lives. And Lord, we'll be sure and crown it all back to you, giving you all the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Call you blessed and highly favored. Until next time, God bless you.